Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to this video. Here, I'll be breaking slightly from my usual routine. This is mainly a trials highlight reel, but I'll first preface it with some loadout tips that I feel contain some solid choices going forward in this new meta. Before all that, however, I just wanted to say out loud how much I appreciate those who have watched and liked my videos. I'm especially thankful to those subscribed to watch more of my content. I'm just starting out, but you gotta start somewhere, right? And to those I know personally, to strangers who also tune in, I can't say thank you enough. It means a lot to me. Now on to the rest of the video. Goodness, have I fallen madly in love with my gunslinger this past week. I just can't seem to put him away. In fact, I barely touched any subclass outside of it all through trials. This meta, love it or hate it, has at least done one very good thing: made primaries relevant. And by extension, Bungie's sort of passively buffed gunslingers in the process. The class has always been set up to benefit from smart and calculated precision, but with everyone running around with shotguns the last while, it was tough for the class to find a footing. The super aside, gunslingers don't have the maneuverability and forgiving neutral game of the Night Stalker, nor do they have the weapon handling speed of the Blade Dancer. And now that the focus has been on longer ranged engagements, it's time for the gunslinger's neutral game to shine. Among the couple of ways to set up the gunslinger, I chose to go with the perks that reward precision kills. The incendiary grenade rewards proper placement with massive damage, plus burn DOT for good measure. For Goldie, I begin the match with Gunfighter and then switch to Deadeye mid-round. And the main perks that reward precision are Knife Juggler, which gives instant melee recharge, Gunslinger's Trance, slightly bumping weapon stability, and Chain of Woe, moderately increasing reload speed. These perks synergize well with my weapon loadout, which I'll get to in a second. When I focused on beginning a fight with multiple Guardians with a precision kill, these perks help to make it slightly smoother and faster. The more precision kills I land, the more Trance and Train stack, giving me a leg up on the next engagement. Alright, onto my weapon loadout. This is where the gears start to fit nicely together to make a strong gunslinger neutral game. If I could sum it up in a few words, it would be: reactive reload is meta. So remember, we want to maximize precision kills. So what I'm going with in my loadout is a hand cannon, specifically my IS Luna, which is a god roll, by the way. It has short shot, outlaw, rifle barrel, and reactive reload. Surprise, surprise. And onto the special weapon slot, please don't hurt me, is my Iron Wreath D sidearm. It has the steady hand sight, reactive reload, feeding frenzy, and reinforced barrel. The roles on the two guns are essentially the same, as in they serve basically the same function: get a kill, reload, and that same weapon gains bonus damage for a short time. The only difference is that they are built for two different ranged engagements. Before the last update, I wasn't keen on choosing my Luna over the Vendor Pally, since hand cannons pretty much required both Rifled Barrel and Rangefinder to be effective. But now I found I can land more shots using a rifled-only Luna with relative ease, freeing up the Rangefinder perk slot for more interesting combinations. With the weapon and subclass perks altogether, I found that this loadout can deal with almost any situation with aplomb, with the obvious exception being a cross-map hardscoping sniper. As long as I've come out on top in a 1v1, I often feel confident enough to engage a new opponent shortly after, even if I haven't fully recovered my health. The extra damage from reactive reload is that good. Oh, and in case you weren't aware, reactive reload lets you kill most Guardians with two hand cannon headshots. Cue the montage.
They used a slam.
I got 170 on one of them. He's gonna burn out for sure.
Watch out. Nice, bro.
Got him. Oh, reactive reload for the win, dude. Oh my god. He's inside by himself, I think. Got him.
Is on top.
Looking roly poly over here.
Grabbing res. I don't know what my nade is hitting. Coming back to us. Nice. Nice.
Good teamwork right there. They're here.
Push it around.
My Goldie.
Is that ours?
Yeah.
Okay. Rip. Nice, bro. Is that us?
Me.
Nice.
inside a cave. That blade.
Damn. Nice. I mean, we have a couple rounds of leeway here. Oh, okay. Mm. This is cool. This is fine.
Push up on me, Kel?
This is fine.
Oh, they're pushing now. Oh, they're outside. There they are. You got that kid. That guy's dead. There's another one there. There's one more. Just use your goldie. Kill it. Why not? You get the res anyway. How are you standing in that nade? How are you standing in his nade?
And that'll do it for this instruction/highlight video. Thanks again to my viewers, I have a lot of fun making videos and want to keep it up moving forward. Let me know in the comments what you all think of this video, the loadout, and your thoughts on the update. Until next time. It's up to you.